yes, so thank you. We are Trimdon Brass. I've actually wrote down what I'm going to say. I don't usually, but I've been known to say some choice things, and I'm conscious that there might be people watching elsewhere, so I'm going to stick to what I've wrote. Yeah, so we are Trimdon Brass. We come from the northeast of England, so we've had a bit of a trek to get here. We are a second section band. We've been a second section band for all of 1 year. Woo! Thank you. Before that, we were a third section band, and before that, we were a fourth section band. As recent as sort of 4 years ago, maybe we were a fourth section band. So, and actually, we've stuck to the same players that were with us then, pretty much, with the odd extra here and there. Trimdon Band, just a very short bit of history. Trimdon Band has been a band for about 150 years, originally called Thornley Colliery Band, which is literally another mining village 3 miles from Trimdon. And then in the early 90s, the band moved, relocated to Trimdon and changed its name at the time, Trimdon Concert Brass. And then we sacked off the concert because Lindsay couldn't spell it. so we just Trimdon Brass from that point on. But there is members of the band who were with the band when it was Thornley Colliery Band back in sort of the 80s and things. I mean, Mr. Race at the back on bass. Mr. Race, give us a wave.
Woo!
He's been with the band since about 1935-ish. But yeah, so we've got a lot of members from them. We're going to feature a soloist now, and this soloist is a player who's been with the band forever. Since she was a very little girl. So to play First Light, please welcome Lindsay.
Thank you.
fantastic. So like many brass bands, we contest, we do concerts, but whatever we do, and people who know us, and round here no one does, but people who know us know that wherever we go, we just want to entertain. That's our sole purpose as a band, whether we're doing a contest or a concert, we want to entertain. And that's the plan tonight. So we're going to try and play a variety of pieces. Sometimes when we're picking a programme, I pick pieces that I know the band don't like. And then I get requests from the band that I know I don't like, but I know audiences will. So as we go on, I'll pretend I like all of them, and I love this next one. So it's fantastic. No, I'm sure we'll all know this one and be able to sing along with this, so no more introduction for this one. This is a medley of pieces from The Greatest Showman. Ooh.
Thank you.
Did we like that one?
Yes.
Oh, good, me too. this comes to the part where I promise I won't talk loads between everyone because I'll be here all night, unless we haven't been here all night. I'm just going to give a mention to one person on this one, and that was Ryan on the drums. Ryan, stand up so everyone can give you a clap. So what we've got, and we always pride ourselves on, we have a training band as well, and a lot of the members of the senior band, a lot of, especially the younger ones, if you look over like this side, there's a couple over here, have kind of fed through from the training band, and what we've got at the minute is Alan, who you can probably tell hasn't come from the training band. Alan's basically put together a kind of a little percussion kind of team, and now all of the percussion team, Ryan's been coming for a little while, but our other two percussion section have basically been coming for like a couple of months. So Ryan's like training up the percussion section. So hopefully we'll have a four-man percussion section forever from this point onwards. But yeah, so we do have a lot of like training going on in the band. And like I say, a lot of players in the band come through that training section. We're going to feature another solo now. And hopefully by talking I've gave... have plenty of time to be ready for us. Our next soloist is a flugel solo. She's actually my wife as well. That's not why I've given her a solo. It is why in rehearsals I'm nasty to her more than anyone else, but yeah, she's come to play a solo. Katie actually is a product of the training band. Only a few years ago she was a member of the training band. So Katie's going to play a solo for you tonight. And as I'm introducing this solo, it's a piece called Tears in Heaven. Have you all heard of Tears in Heaven?
Yes.
Good. Now, this the arrangement for this, so when I read, you know, every piece of music, we know this, we're here every week, it tells you composer, it tells you arranger. And it is arranged by Steve Robson. And now some of you might not know, but Steve Robson sat in the room tonight, and he sat just at the back there. He's giving her a wave now. So Steve's a good friend of the band, and he used to live kind of up near us, but he's recently relocated, so now he's actually local to you. You're about an hour away, Steve? Not far. Yeah. So this is Tears in Heaven, arranged by Steve Robson. So when we get to the end, we'll be doing a double clap, because we'll be clapping for Katie playing it, and we'll be clapping for Steve arranging it. And if he shakes his head, it's because we haven't played it how he intended it. So yes, Tears in Heaven, featuring Katie.
Thank you.
debrief in the car on the way home. She knows I'm joking, I wouldn't dare. Totally different now, like I say, we're trying to please everyone. If we don't, come and let us know something that would please you, and we'll come back another time and play something different. We're now going to play a lovely piece of music, and when I think brass bands, I think some of the best pieces of music were all the Salvation Army pieces. And this is a Salvation Army piece. It's a fantastic piece of music. I heard another band playing it about 2 years ago, and I felt ashamed to say I'd never heard it. Never heard this piece, and about 2 years ago, I was at a contest somewhere, and I heard a band playing this, and as soon as I heard it, I was like, write that down, we're buying it. And honestly, it's a fantastic piece. If you have heard it before, you'll be thinking, how's he never heard this? If you haven't heard it before, I hope you're going to love it. It's a piece called Lavenham.
Thank you.
say I've got to apologise to the band. I pick some, I pick programmes that's just like constant playing for some people in the band. What we're going to do now, I did mention before about training band. We've got a lot of youngsters who come through the training band. We're going to play something now that you'll all know. It's called I Dreamed a Dream. And if you know this arrangement of I Dreamed a Dream, you know that there's a big section of it, what's solo corner plays is like a one only solo corner. But what we're going to do is we're going to give the solo corner to rest from having to play that, and we're going to feature one of our training band members. Well, no, sorry. She was a training band member a few years ago. She's obviously not now. She's in the senior band. So actually, play part of the solo corner part. So she's going to stand up and do it as a proper solo, because why not, eh? So Hannah is our rep player, and Hannah is going to play the solo corner part for I Dreamed a Dream with the band. So this is I Dreamed a Dream featuring Hannah on corners.
Thank you.
So we're going to finish this half with a piece that's kind of relevant to something that's happened recently. But before I do that, I just want to speak a little bit about the band once more before we play this last piece this half. So we spoke about the training band, we spoke about kind of younger players coming through the band and then staying with the band for a long time. Something else that we kind of pride ourselves on as a band, that actually we have members who've been members. And I know I joked about Racy at the back there, Mr. Stephen Race, but he has actually been with the band for 40 years, more? 50 years. So he has actually been with the band for 50 years. Lindsay has been with the band like probably over 30 years. I know that's giving away that her age might be more than 30, but she has. And there's others. And another thing, and this, you might say this has been, sounds like a bit of a strange band. We've got a lot of relations in the band. We do. So we've got, where do we start? So Stephen, other Stephen, Stephen Wicks at the back, is married to Jenna, who's sat here. And then this Hannah, who just played as Stephen's daughter. So that's good. Obviously, I've already said I'm out of Katie. Jeff on first baritone. I nearly said married here, isn't. His brother's with Paul on horn, so we've got brothers in the band. Who am I missing out? Or Lee on bass over there. And Steph are engaged to be married. And then Stuart on euphonium and Holly on cornet are engaged to be married. And who else is there?
Lindsay and Lisa.
Oh, Lindsay and Lisa are sisters. Jamie is Wayne's stepson. Don't look at Jen as I say this one. Wayne and Stephen have been best man for each other a total of 4 times. that's actually not a lie, they have. 2 each, isn't it? Is it 2 each now?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. But we don't talk about that. But yes, so as a band, we are a very family-orientated band, and that's what we love about the band. And we want the band to do well, we want the band to succeed, but we just want the band to be happy. And we do feel that as a band, we are quite a happy band, and hope that comes across. We're going to finish this half with a piece, like I say, quite relevant for something recently. So this piece is a piece called Lovely Jubilee, and it was actually arranged for the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. We churn it out every year for some kind of occasion. So we thought, why not now? She's just had a big, big celebration. So I finish this half, and I've counted how many bodies I can see, and there better be this many when we come back in the second half. This is an arrangement by Gavin Somerset called Lovely Jubilee, and I'm sure you'll recognise a lot of the tunes that are in it. So thank you for listening. We will be back for more fun and such. Lovely Jubilee. We'll be right back.
Thank you.